What is going on, guys? It is Shawin with another video for you. We got a bit of an awesome haul today, guys. I can't express the awesomeness. You can see actually some of it right up here behind me, but we'll get to that probably last. But a few pre-orders actually came, or I should say a couple pre-orders came. Well, a few if you count them. But we do have the first one I'm going to show you is from Mondo. I pre-ordered this with the Iro Monsters exclusive that they got. I'm still waiting on those because those release, I think, next year. But I love Iro Monsters, and that set they brought is fantastic. I love it. And I don't really have anything Iro Monsters other than the complete series on DVD, so I was really happy to order those and start a little bit of a Iro Monsters collection. But through Mondo, the other thing I pre-ordered through them was this, and I thought this was going to go with my other pre-orders based on how they said shipping happens, but not so much. They went ahead and shipped it out, which is really cool. But it's a Tiki mug. It was a special All Hallows Eve edition Tiki mug, and you can see some of the artwork on the box here, which is really cool. I really love the artwork, which is what drew me to it, and obviously the color scheme. Green's my favorite, but orange and black, man, that's Halloween, and that is right up my alley, too. Those are my next favorite colors. So, Splendor and Riches is what this one is called, and they say that because I believe that's what the quote on the Tiki mug itself actually says, and I'll show you that Tiki mug right now. Check this out. And this is gorgeous. I mean, obviously, you can tell it's all 3D sculpted, printed. I'm gonna say it was sculpted. This is actually really detailed. Very, very cool. I'll never drink out of it. I mean, I do have a couple other Tiki mugs as well. I'm not a huge Tiki guy per se, but sometimes cups like this just gravitate and just right to me, and I'm just like, yeah, that's amazing. I love it. Very happy to get this. Check out. And this is where I say Splendor and Riches is the phrase that they have put on the cup itself, but you got the Reaper here and just mounds of skulls and bones all over the place, which this is just beautifully done. Like, this is just amazing. I love the hourglass. I mean, it's all great. And again, this is Mondo. I believe they still had some of these on their website, even though it was a limited edition. I can't believe these haven't sold out yet. Very, very cool. And I'm so happy to have that. The next one I'm going to show you. We actually have two packages, because I don't know why they came separate. Tapes from the Crypts. I can't thank you enough, Tim over there. We've been talking with him, the Goosebumps crew and I, trying to do a collaboration of sorts with his event through Cryptid Videos. And they're going to be doing that this weekend, actually, so go check that out. I will be hoping to have them at our Horrorland convention once we actually get that going. You know, we're in the process right now of working still behind the scenes, getting all that set up. It won't be this year, just FYI for Horrorland. It'll be next year. But it is coming, guys. It is coming, I promise. We are working very hard to make that happen. But he was cool enough. I did order the jersey, and I do like to say when he did his orders for Goosebumps, I only had money at the time for the jersey. He was cool enough for doing a collab with him. Said he was going to send me a shirt too, and he did. And I thank you very much for that, Tim. It's awesome, brother. I appreciate it. I'm going to show you the jersey first, because I like to say now that I'm going to be the Kevin Smith of Goosebumps. You know, big guy with a beard, hat backwards. Now I have the hockey jersey. So let's check this out. So this thing, man, feels so well made. The front, you know how much I love the G-Splat. Probably my favorite logo. That and a Batman logo, you know what I mean? Batman symbol. But that G-Splat's amazing, you know. And of course you got the that lovely slime green on the sleeves and at the bottom, typical hockey style. The back is amazing as well. Goosebumps 92. And this is all stitched. Love it. I love this. I love this so much. I cannot wait to wear this. Definitely wearing it in the next podcast episode. Let me tell you that right now. Because, again, I am now the Kevin Smith of Goosebumps. So, and this was the shirt he was kind enough to send to me. If you were have seen his work, you saw this shirt up for order as well. Very cool. Of course, it's got... It's upside down. It ain't gonna help you out, is it? I guess that would be better if I did this. Just... I'm not even gonna edit that out. Just gonna leave it. Just gonna leave it. This is real. This is real. You know, I got the Goosebumps, Haunted Mask, Mud Monster, The Horror, Slappy, Mr. Stein right here, which is really cool. I don't know why we never see shirts or anything with Stein on there, but I think that needs a change. I got Curly over here, one of the newer designs of Curly. And then, of course, you got Drool down here with the, I like to call it the Tim Jacobus skeleton. But yeah, man, Boo Dude, classic saying from the 90s on all that stuff. And then, of course, they got stuff on the back, which I love, you know. I like designs on backer shirts. I feel like if you're going to spend the money you spend on shirts now, they need to really go all out. If it's a long sleeve, it needs to have stuff on it. It needs to have stuff on the front and back. So, reader beware, you're in for a scare. And this time, you know, it's right side up, you know, not upside down. And, of course, you got that lovely G-Splat right here. Of course, being my favorite logo, the G-Splat. Last thing I'm going to show you guys to wrap up this video, what came in today. Again, surprising it came because it wasn't supposed to be shipped to me until like the 13th or something. But Barnes & Noble went ahead and sent out the other three regular editions. The Werewolf Fever Swamp is not supposed to be shipping until October 22nd or something, I believe, at this point. So I'll be getting that later. At this point, you'll be seeing it all over the place, though, with everybody who has it. The only other one I need to get now is the regular Haunted Mask whenever that actually goes up for order. But we'll start with Bad Hair Day. I'll try to keep the glare off of here. I've already got these in the plastic protectors, so that was the first thing I did to try to keep these all nice and crisp, because how long we waited for Goosebumps Pops, I definitely don't want these to be jacked up. These did arrive pretty much perfect. I mean, if you see anything on here, it's probably the case itself. I've had them for a while. But Bad Hair Day looks great. And then you got Bjorn's boy Slappy. I've seen some people say they didn't quite like the design of Slappy, and I kind of see where you're coming from. Maybe the head's too wide. Maybe they should have made the head a little slimmer, but that's not what Funko Pops are. You know what I mean? The Funko Pops are stylized in that big head format. So it makes sense to have it a little bit wider as opposed to, like, tall and slender. But it looks great. Like, I love the packaging they put on this. I love the tombstone design. It's perfect. And what's really cool is, like, I really like that you probably can't see it very well, but in the back behind the Pops, they actually do have, like, a backdrop to it of the book cover, kind of like what you see in the Werewolf Fever Swamp, which is more prominent because it's bigger. But I think that's a nice touch. Now, I will say the Werewolf Fever Swamp, that one, or not Werewolf Fever Swamp, I'm sorry, the Blacklight edition of the Haunted Mask that's up here. That one only has a black background, which I totally kind of get, you know, black light, black background. But I assume the Haunted Mask is obviously going to have, the regular version is going to have the backdrop like these do. And I can't wait to see that. I'm just dying to get it. So, last one though, the Mask Mutant. Yeah! If you know, you know. But absolutely awesome. Honestly, this turned out fantastic. I love this. I think it's amazing. Actually, one of the best. I mean, I love all these Pops. To be completely honest, which surprised me, because like when we saw the announcement of which ones they're gonna do, I fully did not expect Bad Hair Day, or Attack the Mutant. Slappy and the Haunted Mask, I think, were givens. Werewolf Fever Swamp, I get. That's a fan favorite, too. But the other two were kind of a surprise. I am glad they did the Masked Mutant, though. I am definitely going to have Scott Wickware get one of these and have him sign it for me. So I think that's going to be awesome. But that is it, guys. That is all I got for today. I really hope you enjoyed this video, if you stuck to the end. And happy Halloween, guys. It is going to be a great month. I hope to have some content for you soon. Pumpkin patches, a haunted house, something, you know what I mean? I am going to be in a haunted house, so I will take you on that adventure as well and show you that video when it's done. That is going to be the weekend of the 19th. So the 18th and 19th, I'm in a haunted house as a scare actor, so I will definitely share that with you guys and share my costume. It's all pretty much done. I'm just waiting on the mask, so which is on the way to me. I'm hoping I'll get it soon, but it was coming from a maker over in Russia, and I bought from him before, and if you saw my costume last year, it's the same mask maker who made that one. So it's going to be epic. So till next time, guys, followers beware, you're in for a scare.